Make that big boss less special. It ain't no game, but they saying welcome to the second level.
How's it going, guys, and welcome back to Level 2 VR, where we escape reality to bring you the news, virtually. And today it's myself, Tom, and my buddy Keegan, as per usual.
That's him.
I would like to, before we start, give a special shout-out to r/PSVR.
Yeah, can I give it a special shout-out once you're going through your special shout-out?
Sure. So I wanted to give a special, one-time, shout-out to r/PSVR. We posted our last week's video for you guys on a whim. And here's the thing, guys, and I totally get it, like, for the people that were commenting and saying, oh, please don't let this devolve into, like, a YouTube posting video thing. A spammy thing. We hate that too. Like, we haven't done that for 2 years because it's annoying.
And like, we've lurked in the community. You've been in it
I've been more than I have.
I've
been a solid member of the community for a while, but I don't like spammy YouTube links. And so I felt shitty putting it up, but I was just like, you know what? It couldn't hurt considering the amount of stuff that we do that is directly from that forum.
So thank you.
They are my news source, alongside a few other things, but they are a primary news source for me just because it is.
They usually have it before the people.
It's an amalgamation, yeah, of all these other, like, websites and stuff, so it's really easy to get that. So massive shouts to you guys. We won't, like, post this up, I don't think. We're just going to assume that the people that watched the last one and joined us were happy about it and wanted to keep watching. So this won't go up there, but if you're watching us and you were there because of that thing,
thank you.
What's your special shout
out? My special shout out was, I was playing Werewolves Within again the other night, and
you love that game.
Ran into, yeah, my favorite PSVR game now. Mm. Me and David played. You didn't join because you had to do adult things like clean a kitchen.
Yeah, I know.
Stupid.
Sorry.
Dumb.
I have a wife.
I know.
And dogs.
I know.
And a house.
But no, I ran into a couple people. We were talking, like, we were waiting for the game to get matchmaked, to have enough people to start a game, and we were talking, and a few of those people were from the RPSVR group, so that was kind of cool. I guess, I don't want to say I met them in person, because I didn't technically meet them in person, but I heard their voices, didn't see their text, and it was kind of cool, because we're like, yeah, there's one dude that's like, yeah, I checked it every day. I was like, oh, sweet, and I was like, everybody else who's not here, isn't a part of it, go look at it, because it is one of the best communities. I'm scared of Reddit. I've said it many times to you. I'm scared of Reddit, because you hear horror stories of people just getting shat on, and, like, link dropping and all that kind of stuff, and it just... Not that it's an evil place,
move.
but it's also a really cool place that communities can grow and develop, and that's why it gets a bad reputation, because if somebody does break the rules or does something that's like, this is a bit sketchy, like, hey, that's not cool here.
Reddit,
which
can
I respect.
Be a fickle beast, but also a gallant master. And I think that r/PSVR is one of the better subreddits out there. So
it's the nicer one.
Go and check them out. Say hi. Tell them we sent you. And then moving on to the actual stuff that you came to watch us for. Let's talk about Starblood Arena. Because Starblood Arena Let's talk about Starblood, because it officially got its pre-order put up today at $40 for Starblood. Starblood is one of those games that has been on, you know, super hype mode from Sony since they talked about it originally, and a lot of folks are getting, like, progressively more excited about it. We recently spoke about how they had a single player campaign added to it, which is, like, great news for me. Not so much for him, but, you know, that's where you get more gamers, is by giving more content. And alongside the fact that it's a pre-order, one of the new segments I had in here, and I may as well talk about it now since it's relevant, is that Starblood Arena has gone gold. And when we say gold, that's nothing to do with sales. This isn't like album sales.
No.
This is talking about the gold master. So that means that they officially
the retail version.
Right, exactly. They've officially made the Golden Master, which means that it's not far behind, which is why we're seeing a pre-order show up.
Which is
this
then
week.
Also, so what? A lot of times, what happens with games after they go gold is then they work on a patch, because there's usually stuff that, because they have a date they have to hit. It's a business. You have a timeline you have to hit, and they still, every game's gonna have some sort of bugs.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's stuff that they work on between when it goes gold and when it launches. That's why there's a lot of day one patches. So it'd be interesting to see what happens there, but I'm excited it's gone gold. I don't know much about this game. I watched the trailer for it, and I think my only concern is that it looks a lot like a lot of other games on PSVR.
It looks kind of like Eve and what have you. I mean, here's the thing about it.
But if it's good,
it's going to be completely reliant on the locomotion.
I had no voice there. Do you hear that? But it's good.
The locomotion is going to make or break that game, I think. Yeah. If you're looking at games like Eve and those sort of space shooters that are right there for PSVR, some of those do it really right as far as locomotion. And even though you're kind of spinning around in 360-degree space, you don't necessarily get disorientated. Other ones, though, will just make you want to vomit immediately. I believe you had trouble with, is it Eve, because of the vomitiness?
Eve, I never got sick from it, but I got woozy quite a few times where, right. Like, I would do the up and over maneuver, and that would be the one that every, like, I couldn't do that, or barrel rolls.
Right.
It was, like, and even on roller coasters, like, I'm fine on a roller coaster when a roller coaster goes in a loop, but if a roller coaster has a corkscrew, that always makes me get sick. That's the only time I've ever gotten
sick. It's mostly a personal thing.
Yeah.
But also, let's not forget there are... now, at least, companies have mostly figured out comfort settings pretty well. So hopefully they give everyone the option to either go full comfort or full, you know, hardcore into it if they have their VR legs.
Go full hardcore.
Go full hardcore.
That's the best way to go.
Space core. And, you know, so the thing about Starblood that's kind of interesting is the way they're talking about it and hyping it up with the Gold Master and everything is they're actually sort of going through the different characters and they're trying to get you to know the characters more. And the last big game that came out that I could think of that was a big part of how they were introducing it was Overwatch. Because Overwatch clearly puts a lot of time into their characters and the designs.
I don't know. Overwatch, it's a small game. I don't think it did anything.
Right. So Starblood looks like basically kind of like Overwatch in space, man. You get to fly a spaceship around, shoot people, their shields. And all kinds of other stuff, obviously customization options. But go check out more info on Starblood Arena. If you want to check out the trailer that they dropped for the Gold Master release, then that will be below in the description. So feel free to click that and go through. And then we had our new releases for the week. There was two this week for PSVR. Mm-hmm. And those were Mortal Blitz, which has been pretty exciting for a lot of folks. Mortal Blitz has come up a couple times on r/PSVR, amongst other places. And Mortal Blitz looks like a really well done on rail shooter,
which is surprising to say that sentence.
Yeah, I mean, on rail shooters do pretty good in PSVR or in VR in general.
Yeah.
I think everyone was kind of stoked on Until Dawn, and so the fact that it is on rails a little bit, but I don't know how on rails it is. I haven't actually played it at this point. Looking at it, it looks to be almost like a really kind of well graphically thought out dystopian-ish version of like a Time Cop or one of those types of games you used to play in the arcade where you would like duck behind a box and then boom 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 and then duck. So the
Time Crisis.
Was that what it was called?
Time Crisis.
Okay, there you go. One of them.
I went to the arcade like three times in my life, but I played the crap out of that game.
I think Time Cop was a movie with Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Yeah.
My bad. So anyway, it looks like one of those. It looks cool, man. It's pretty exciting. It's only $20. So as far as how long the experience is,
we say it every week. Yeah, Time Crisis was that game. Sorry. We say it every week, but it's like one of those things where like PSVR games, I feel like 9 times out of 10 are priced appropriately for what they are.
Yeah, it's fair.
That it kind of sucks to say that because it's like, well, it's a $20 game, it's not a full experience, but I'd rather have that than a $60 game that I'm pissed about, and then I'm mad at the PSVR headset because the games are so expensive that I can't buy more games.
Yeah.
Versus like right now with every game being, I mean not every game, but a lot of games being, I would say between the $15 and $30 range, you can pick up more.
And I think that's what's happened.
Like
is a lot
like.
Of people that buy VR games buy them en masse. They buy. I probably have more VR games than I have standard like AAA, AA games at this point. Just because I get super excited about. I have tons more indies.
Yeah.
But I get super excited about them coming out, and I always kind of want to get into that new experience. And that's the part of the addiction of VR and the fact that you know we're starved for this attention as far as gamers go. And so Mortal Blitz looks like it might fill a few little gaps in the shooty department. There was recently a patch to Lethal VR as well, by the way, and so that's another one that if you like shooting galleries is obviously worth picking up, but thought I'd throw that out there. And the other game is not really a game.
Yeah, it's weird. I watched the trailer for it this morning and I was like,
the trailer's interesting.
At first I was like, because of my first thought, you want to say what it is first?
Sure.
Start
it's Viri. Viri VR.
So my first thought was, I thought Connectimals.
Okay.
My very first thought
but
was
real.
Yeah, well, kind of, because like at first I couldn't tell if it's CG or not, because you have the what is it, monkeys that swing in front of you, mm-hmm. And I was like, this looks like it could be real, but it looks like it could be CG because CG's gotten that good. But then
I think it's real. Yeah, I mean, I haven't played it yet, but it's essentially a 360 safari experience. is the best way to explain it. So you're talking about really high fidelity footage. Keegan and me were sort of talking about it earlier. He was mentioning the screen door effect and how that might have some kind of a potentially bad effect on clarity and things like that. But I think anyone that's currently tried to put like a 360-degree video or streamed a 360-degree video from YouTube on a PSVR headset notices that they look like shit. Like, they're just so, it's potato quality, like gaming or videos at the very least. And that's just because they have to be so much better and so optimized for that headset for you to enable to see it with any kind of clarity whatsoever. So Viri, I'm hoping, is an exception to that general rule right now of having like shitty quality stuff.
I'm on a link here, and this is from pushsquare.com. While this isn't 3D footage and subsequent lack of depth that you may be used to in virtual reality, it is some of the highest quality 360-degree video we've witnessed thus far.
Great.
All the clips have been shot in 4K, and while it's obviously a higher resolution than Sony's headset can display, it means that the image quality is at the best you can expect from the device, which is a good thing to hear.
I wonder if it's that much better on a Pro. Because weren't we talking about how the Pro got that kind of upgrade with the firmware?
I mean, it will be better on the Pro than it will be on the base PS4. I like this line, by the way. It's not just the quality of the video that makes this appealing, though. It's the content, too. Coming literally nose-to-nose with the zebra is an opportunity that you're unlikely to have in real life. Even if you physically went on a safari, you're unlikely to get that close to animals.
Words. They are your.
I was gonna say my word, and then I read a different word, and then it didn't go well.
So anyway, Viri VR.
It looks interesting. It's what, eight?
It's $10.
$10.
So Viri VR. It's a Safari 360 cam thing.
It's an experience, not a game per se.
There is some interactive elements to it, but not many.
It's one of those things we kind of talked about. I can't remember what the one we were talking about. Oh, with like Time Machine, like something like this. I would love to see this, but then I'd love to see, like, DLC. I hate to say that because I hate DLC to a certain extent because that means I got to spend more money. But I would love to see, like, okay, you're in a safari. Next time you're underwater. Next time you're here. Next, like, the
whole
different
things. Yeah, they could totally do, like, a mountain version of this or an underwater version of this.
I've been doing a lot recently with PSVR when it comes to, like, videos. Those of you who know Markiplier on YouTube, he's kind of a big...
Who's that guy?
He's kind of a big dude on YouTube. For April Fool's, he did a 360-degree video, and I was like, I watched it on my phone, and I did this thing. I was like, that's cool. I was like, let me watch this in PSVR, because you're inside of it. And I was like, this is so awesome. Mm-hmm. Like, the fact that I have this... A, that I have a unit that can do this, and B, it's just a whole different experience, and I've gotten more and more... Like, yes, it's not the greatest image quality, but I've gotten more and more used to what it's going to look like in VR that I now watch. My preferred method as of right now, and it might just because I'm honeymoon phase, is to watch movies in VR, even if it's a flat movie. Because
feel like you have an IMAX strapped to your face.
Yes. Yeah. And I don't... The weird part, though, is I don't feel like I have a thing on my face. A lot of time. You forget about it. I mean, you realize you're in VR.
Sink in a little bit.
But you're like, oh, I'm watching
a movie. I went and picked up a couple more 3D Blu-rays after my experience with those, and I'm excited to kind of push that path forward. All the really, really good ones, like Avatar and Tron and stuff, are like really expensive. Still, you can get
I have Avatar in 3D.
You do?
Yeah.
Nice. On Blu-ray?
I'm pretty sure I do.
Test it. See what it looks like in PSVR.
I've watched... So the movies I watched, I just got Fantastic Beasts.
Okay.
It's not in 3D, but I'm going to watch that in VR and kind of see my opinions on that. Our friend Sunny is like, you need to watch... She knows I'm a big Harry Potter fan.
Oh, yeah, you'll
She's
like
you
it.
You need to watch it. So, like I said, my preferred method, and it's funny because I never thought that would be the case because, again, I'm very much a video guy, and not that image quality is the end all be all, but it is I bought a Panasonic ST50 because it had the best image quality out there. It's a plasma, blacks are blacks, whites are whites. Like, that's why I bought that TV. And now that I'm watching it in this VR headset, I'm like, I don't fucking care about my TV 10 feet away because I got a big TV.
Different experience. So, there you go. Keep bringing those to us, developers. I think those 360 videos, especially if you can do them in non-potato quality.
And if you want to experience more that aren't necessarily... If you don't want to just experience a 360 video, YouTube app. YouTube is built for VR. Hulu now has VR support. Mm-hmm. I've not watched anything
Little
in
Star,
VR.
A couple of those other guys that you can download.
Invasion
content.
Is a good one if you like cartoony stuff. But there's a lot of them out there. And I mean, obviously, PSVR, a lot of people are going to play the games. But these experiences don't... look beyond them. Like, do try a couple of them out, see what you think.
The headset does more than you think it does.
Yes, which is exciting.
and how you can do more than you think you can with your wallet. There's also a couple deals going on this week. Number one,
Werewolves Within again?
No, it's
that's
not.
Been on sale like 3 weeks. Merville's,
actually, our good buddy.
We just
Merville's.
Bought that.
Yeah, we did. Which Sony. But Merville's VR drops to $15 from $20.
I thoroughly
enjoyed
that game.
Neat little game.
It reminded me of like a Zelda. It's again third person games for
it's
whatever reason in VR.
It's essentially
an
N64 like quality. Game, but in VR.
Yes,
like that's the graphical fidelity you're talking about. But it is
it's like Mario 64 style
platformer. Yeah, so definitely cool, worth checking out. Don't overlook it. $15 is a good time to snatch it up. I don't see it getting much cheaper than that for
anytime soon,
because it is still like only a couple weeks old.
What do you
so,
do? You think they're gonna do? They've got to do like a 1 year like mass discount on PSVR games. That would be awesome.
I would hope so.
I would love that.
Yeah.
When's the anniversary?
We'll get into that. So the last part of the deal section is this is something that isn't starting until April 5th, so by the time you watch this, it should be up. Eve Valkyrie and Eve Gunjack are doing a gigantic sale for the 5th of April through the
26th. Is it a huge sale, Tom? It's a huge sale. It's the biggest sale you've ever seen.
It's the best sale. So it's Eve Valkyrie 50% off and Gunjack 60% off. And as we already talked about, Gunjack is the top selling PSVR game, which already is weird.
You said 50% off the Eve game?
60 off Gunjack, 50 off Eve.
One of my biggest complaints at launch is I bought Eve. And it's not the game itself, it's how much I paid for the game. It's one of those things.
It was pricey. I mean, $60 is a big ask.
Yeah, where I feel like I bought the game and had different expectations for that game versus like Batman or whatever else I got at launch. Like you have a different expectation because you're paying a full price and I expected it to be a quote unquote full game. I hate using that term, but it's the truth.
I think the elements of multiplayer that were put into that price decision as well, though, because Batman being a single player experience of questionable length, you put that against like Eve Valkyrie, which is an online game.
But if you compare it to
a single player,
comparing it to like Eve Valkyrie, like the single player in the Eve Valkyrie, I don't think was that good because it's the same as online.
Yeah,
it
wasn't great.
So that's my complaint. But for $30. I would say
more
do
likely,
it.
Yeah.
Yes,
more likely.
That's
like good experience.
It's not a bad game. I just didn't like it for $60.
Yeah, that's fair. So yeah, that starts on April 5th through to the 26th. So you've got a little while to get your mitts on Eve. So moving on to the news, and as you so eloquently put earlier, we are fast approaching the 6 month anniversary of PSVR.
Mm-hmm.
That is going to be April 13th. So let's talk about it. Where are you at in your opinions?
In VR?
6 months in. Yeah.
So as you know, when it launched, I did that launch weekend stream and kind of was all into it and ready to go. I texted you constantly that day, just like, hey. Can I get the unit? Because the unit was coming to you.
Mm.
And I was like, can I get the unit? Can I get the unit? No. Can I get the unit? No. Tom, I need to get the unit.
He asked me for my unit all the time. It's really
I was like, can I get it? But no, I played a lot that weekend. Did my fix of the games we had at the time.
You had a solid like 3 day
Yeah. Stop playing it.
Yeah.
Played AAA games. I'm now getting back into the kick of it. Like I said, Werewolves, thanks to our buddy David for buying that for my birthday. It's a fun game. And there's a lot of games like Marvels, and I think what my issue was, and this is what our YouTube channel is for, is to figure out what games are good and what games are bad, and RPSVR helps with that as well as other sites that exist.
I almost check that forum before every purchase, because I've made those purchases where like something comes out and I'm just like, ooh, yes, $10, grab it. And then I go there later in the day and then everyone's like, ooh, don't do it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, ooh, fuck. You know? But I'm starting to listen now.
But I'm glad there's a library, which is what makes me excited, and I can go back and play them, and I can kind of like do that binge thing. But I'm happy we have the headset. Granted, we were given it to us from our viewers, full disclosure, but it's awesome that we have VR in our life, and I do think, like I said day one, I think it's a new way to play games, and I think it's a new gameplay experience that nobody can deny.
I think it's delivered on all of those fronts.
The only complaint I have right now is there's no AAA game for me.
That's fair.
Resident Evil is out,
that's
and I
fair,
know it's a great game.
But also, AAA games are something that's a big discussion for VR, because there's a lot of people that just automatically assumed that there was just going to be like a massive pipeline of them available.
I don't expect that, but I want a few.
I'm just talking in general terms here. So, you know, with a AAA game, especially in VR, you got to think about how much time goes into something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So there were certain companies that took a bigger risk at the beginning of its life cycle, Capcom being one of them, to
Arkham,
create something.
Batman. I mean...
Right. I mean, even that, though, was only like a couple hours. I mean, I think Resident Evil really pulled the wheel back on that, because they were just like, okay, fuck it, the whole thing, VR, let's do it. And they made their flat game at the same time. So, you know, that was really brave of them to go about and trying to make that a fully fledged experience in both the regular game and VR. Yeah, I mean, that's a lot of force behind that. So I think for those people that are just like, oh, just give me a RPG in VR or whatever and I'll be happy... They're coming, man.
I want Elder Scrolls in VR.
There's been so many.
I want Elder Scrolls in VR. Fallout 4 VR is coming. Like,
that's true.
Not to PSVR, but it's coming to it's coming to Vive. Right. It's officially announced on Vive.
But that's something that I think you have to bear in mind, that these developers want to do that for you. They want to be able to provide that to you. But let's be honest. If they go ahead and make a game that is like glitch-ridden, glitches work differently in VR.
They make you sick in VR.
Yeah, in VR, when something is spazzing out in your face, you can't like you can't escape that. Well, so it's terrifying.
I mean, the game we have at the end of this is Faded. Mm-hmm. The
Silent Oath.
It was like Something Oath. And it had a few moments where the screen would freak out. I mean, it wasn't the end of the world, but it did make me the first few times, I was like, what just happened?
A little jolting.
Yeah. You're like, oh, because it is right here.
So they have to be not only... close to perfect with their quality of game, but also
and frame rate and all that.
Yeah, but like, also like technically, you know, make it viable sometimes in multiple platforms or at least to multiple VR platforms as well, which you know takes some engineering. So they're coming. The current conversations with VR developers, people in the know for VR, they're saying AAA is on the way. It's just going to be a while. I know.
I love VR. I think there's a lot of things for it. My favorite game outside of Werewolves Within, and again, I think that is a quote-unquote Keegan game because it's a social game. It's playing with friends. It's weird being in a public lobby, but you get over that real quick when y'all are like, hey, you made a fart joke. Like, there's somebody yesterday that... he was two people over, and he burped, and the girl next to him goes, that was gross. Like, you're like, oh, it's fucking human. Like, it's another person... And I posted today in one of the gaming groups I'm in on Facebook, Gamers YouTube, shout out, that I'm like, Worlds Within has made me realize that not all gamers are dicks. Like, because I very rarely play with the public.
Well,
the thing about it
as well is that Werewolves Within, the nature of the game is for conversation.
Yes.
It's for, like, you play the game the same way you would play it around a tabletop. So it's not quite the same thing as, like, playing Call of Duty
where you're shooting somebody.
Where you want to fuck everyone's mother. It's a little different. And I think because of that, it breeds a certain type of community.
Yes.
Mostly people that do that play tabletop games and that at very least would not be a dick at a tabletop because they realize that the whole point of people's enjoyments of the game comes out of
it. But what's really cool is you can vote to kick people out. We had an asshole a couple times ago and I'm like, we're going to kick you. Like, nobody, you can vote. It doesn't tell you who started the vote to kick, which I like because everybody likes anonymity when you're doing something like that because you don't want to be the guy that's like, oh, fuck you. But there's one dude that was like, let's get him out of here. I voted kick him and group agreed and he was gone.
Fair enough.
Problem solved. But the one thing I wish there was a little bit more of is the Move games. I think we have gotten to the point where there's a lot of DualShock 4, which I knew there was going to be a lot of those games, but I want more Moves because I get more immersed with like Job Simulator or...
Do you think that's a limitation of the hardware, though?
Kind of. It's also, again, getting back to your point of how much more effort that's going to take.
Yeah.
That's the other thing is... I love the ones where you can reach and grab and do all these different
clipping
things.
Clipping has been kind of an issue since launch, and they've gotten better at certain things, tracking, clipping, that kind of stuff. It's still not perfect. There's still some drift. There's still some
You're using a light to track.
There's a lot to go wrong with playing VR games. But more move games would be nice.
And the other thing I want to say is I feel like the updates that are coming when it comes to like not just game things, but like the firmware update 2.0. 3D Blu-rays. I didn't even think about that.
Yeah,
like it was. I mean, it was one of those things where, like, you think about it. Like, again, for YouTube, it made sense. For like Hulu, it makes sense. For digital streaming platforms, but I didn't even think about it because I don't use my PS4 to play Blu-rays. I have a Blu-ray player attached to my TV, and like
most of my Blu-rays are in a crate somewhere because I watch everything digitally. So this made me want physical. And honestly, if it was a digital thing, I'd still buy them digitally.
Yeah.
But it made me want physical just so I could experience that again because I had so much of a good time with watching Prometheus in 3D. So yeah.
So they're really good at surprising you with stuff you didn't know you wanted until they give it to you, and then you want it. It's like the Apple mentality sometimes, where it's like, oh, here's the thing that you probably didn't think about.
You didn't know it exists, but now it's
like Touch ID.
Indispensable to your life.
I mean, prime example, Touch ID. I have an iPhone 6 Plus. I had the iPhone 5 for the longest time, and I was like, I don't need Touch ID. What's the point? Now I couldn't imagine having a phone without Touch ID. Like, stupid shit like that.
Yeah, so good on you, Sony. I think they really couldn't be in a stronger position right now. I mean,
their units sold. That's the other thing where the developers are going to get on board.
They know there's a base. I think the players that are playing are buying a lot of games, which is good for developers.
And units are available.
It's still the only console that has a dedicated VR unit for it.
And Microsoft won't. Microsoft has come out and said they will not. They will support the HTC and they support the Vive, but they will do it in a very funky way.
They're not going to make it. And that's the thing. So with Sony having a hand in the hardware and the software for these devices means that they can optimize it to a certain extent.
And it can't be cheap. That's the real reason I think Microsoft's not doing it, because they're working on HoloLens, which who knows if that'll be gaming or not.
Yeah.
It's not cheap to be first.
They show Minecraft quite a lot with HoloLens.
Yeah, but who knows? I mean, who knows if that's just a prototype.
Augmented reality is one thing. Yeah. Virtual reality so far, Sony, you've kicked it off almost in the same fashion as Bluetooth. Not Bluetooth, Blu-ray. Thank you.
I mean, Bluetooth was pretty fancy too.
That's true. but it was a Viking. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah, it's I forget his first name, but Bluetooth is named after a Viking king.
No. Oh.
There you go. I learned
that. Was his name Bluetooth?
His name was something Bluetooth, yeah. I forget the first part. Google it. Anyway, so moving on with some of the news. First of all, you know, happy 6-month anniversary. But then we also had a couple good reveals this week. One of the best ones that I saw was something called Invisible Hours, which you probably don't know much about. I don't think you've seen the trailer for this one yet.
It's funny because, like, when we do these shows, you do the VR stuff, like, because you love, I don't want to say you love them more than I do, but you're definitely way more into that community than I am, versus, like, for me, I look at the YouTube stuff, and I look at, like, the news I tend to get a lot more when it comes to the flat stuff, like, mm-hmm.
That's why you
Mass
do
Effect.
The bargain basement yes. news, and I do the VR news.
Yes, yeah. That's why. But it's funny, because you come with these things, and I'm like, oh, I did not know that was a thing.
Yeah, so we both get to learn. We all learn together.
We know a little bit what's happening. But.
So Invisible Hours is, and I think this is great for VR. You know, I like my crime games. I like my crime TV shows.
Is
I like
Sherlock
my
Holmes?
Crime stuff. It is a Sherlock Holmes-style game in VR.
Basically, you're an old man.
I am an old man.
Okay, cool.
But it's totally a whodunit in VR. It looks like an Agatha Christie / Sherlock Holmes-y type story, where it's kind of, it almost looks like, I think the book or the show is called And Then There Were None. You know, where they, like, a group of, like, 10 people get invited to a mansion, and, like, one mm-hmm. by one they drop off. It looks like that, but in VR. And, of course, you know, you have to wander around this place looking for clues, and, like, shit happens while you're there. I don't know how scary it is. But yeah, we'll drop the trailer in the description below as always for that. But Invisible Hours reveal trailer came out and it looks perfect for VR. I'm really excited about this game. So go and check out that below and let us know what you think, if you think it looks worth it or not. We talked about Starblood already. So moving on, if you've ever seen the TV show The Expanse, if you haven't,
no.
It's a sci-fi show, but it's a sci-fi show on sci-fi. So that usually makes it a shitty sci-fi show. But this one is not a shitty sci-fi show. From everything I understand, I'm like seashells by the seashore over here.
Dude, so earlier when we were testing whether I was thinking of getting rid of my pop filter because sometimes it covers my face.
Yeah, you can.
But I tried a Peter Pepper pick up peppers. How many people
that was
did
great.
You ever
that
pick?
Was, yeah, spot on.
Nailed
so,
it. I can't do that.
So anyway, The Expanse was recommended by our good buddy Jordan, and most of his recommendations are solid. So I still haven't had a chance to watch it all the way through yet. Started watching it. Wife hated it. That means we don't get to watch it. So The Expanse is shut up. So it's a sci-fi thing starring, I believe, Tom Jane. Tom Jane, you may remember from the good Punisher movie. It looks pretty cool, man. It's an experience. So it's a VR mini experience, and this is something that a couple shows have done now. Mm-hmm. Remember, Always Sunny in Philadelphia did a VR experience as well, where you're like on the back of a motorcycle or something mm-hmm. and doing stunts and stuff. But yeah, this is a VR experience specifically for The Expanse TV show, and it's on Little Star. So Little Star is an application that should already be on your machine. If not, then download it because it has a ton of cool little cinema experiences in there, and that's a new one. Really, 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 really fresh news as of recording. We only learned this just before. CI Games hints at a Sniper Ghost Warrior VR game. So Sniper Ghost Warrior has a particular following. I don't like it because it has a stupid name. That's what turns me off about it. I'm like, Sniper Ghost Warrior? It sounds like the worst Tom Clancy novel. But, you know, it's it's actually a half decent game, and it has a rabid fan base enough that they've made like what, four of these games at this point, three or four of these games.
It's so, on the third one comes out in 2 weeks.
There you go. So they have mentioned CI that they are planning on doing a VR game. Now I don't
full
know if it's fully
experience.
Fledged.
That's
yeah, I don't know if it's an experience. This
game.
Is early day news. But I could picture that being cool. I mean, if you think
yeah.
about it in VR, especially with a game like that, the only sucky part would be. I believe in the sniper games, like you do your sniping and then mm-hmm. you have to move like from point to point. So the question is, how do you handle the moving? Mm-hmm. Because you don't have any finesse really in VR. So do they handle it like Resident Evil? Do they handle it like...
Teleportation,
Teleportation,
Batman.
Exactly. But if you do teleportation, that takes an element out of the gameplay that's mm-hmm. so in there for sniper. But is that okay if it's a VR game? You know, there's so many questions that remain unanswered about this. Also, do they utilize the new aim peripheral?
Well, what I was thinking, this is real dumb, but the fact that you could do this with that mode is like when you're sniping, a lot of times I think a sniper's laying prone on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And
it almost seems like the perfect game to do that without the moving. Like if the
yes.
moving wasn't involved, it would be great if you could
yeah.
use the aim controller or whatever.
The problem
would,
with the aim controller
is
I think it'd be up like this because it's got the weird hump down here.
I don't know, we've not really had a chance to get hands on, but
it would be cool like if you could have a movement to where the game, I don't know how it would register your body, but if it could register, if you go down low enough, you just lay down or you crouch. Like, obviously crouching's easy, but like laying down, or if you even if you had a button on the light gun to lay you down to go prone, like that to me is really cool. That would immerse me even more than just having a controller to shoot. Again, that's
and also
one,
I
one
feel
of the
like
things I said is more move, more I think more accessory based games,
right. But also the sniper games, obviously those are played with the DS4, so you know when you're balancing your aim and the wind and all that kind of shit that you go mm-hmm. into with the sniper game, you're all doing it with just a left stick, right stick. Having to do that like physically with mm-hmm. your like keeping steady your own arms.
And you have a button to, like for breathing, like you
yeah,
hold your breath.
Yeah, it would be a whole different ball game. So really excited news actually from CI Games there, because that's the type of game that could potentially do really well. I wouldn't put it as a AAA, but potentially mm-hmm. a AA VR title if they get it right.
Can I add something real quick into all
sure.
this? So one of the things I played last night when I was on YouTube is there's a Star Wars Rogue One Recon video.
Okay.
That if you do not own Star Wars Battlefront for whatever reason and you have not played the X-Wing Starfighter, whatever, what's it called? I think it's called Battlefront X-Wing VR Mission or something
like
that.
Got,
I think it's if you haven't played that and you don't have the money to buy that, go on YouTube and play. It's called Rogue One Recon, a Star Wars 360 experience. It's on the official Star Wars.
So it's a video.
Yeah, it's official Star Wars YouTube page. And you're sitting in an X-Wing, and it's very much, I don't want to give away too much, but it's very much similar to what that experience is, other than you're not controlling the ship, you're along for the ride. And it was really weird. Not
no such thing.
It.
No such bad thing as more Star Wars, I think,
yes.
is a fair thing to say.
The weird yeah. part was when you had the voice, because you have your headset on, obviously, and you've got the radio voice going on, but then you speak and it's not your voice, you're like, oh, I'm talking. But that's a good Star Wars one. I said I played that last night and had a lot of fun with it.
Awesome.
So
thank
what else you got
that. So World War Toons got a remaster announcement, which is interesting.
So that game, I don't know how I feel about the game. I played the beta at launch, couldn't for the life of me get connected to a match. Like that was the big complaint, was I could not find players, and I don't know if it's just because it was a beta or what, but I couldn't.
They
not
definitely
find
have improved on it since.
Okay.
I've not actually played that game, but from all of the news and things that I've heard, they're also really active in the PSVR, the r/PSVR forums, the team there.
I was real
but
upset, because that one looked like a Keegan game.
Yeah, it does look like a Keegan game, but I'm not sure what they mean by remastered, to be honest with you. The trailer dropped for this remastered announcement, and that, of course, will be in the description below, so watch it and make up your own mind, but it just sounds like they've kind of maybe gotten to the point where it's post beta and it's something that they cleaned up a couple things and it's like a bit neater to play, a bit easier to play. Maybe they fix those network issues, but
hopefully.
Yeah, World War Toons remastered.
If they fix that, I'll go back into it.
Yeah, I would give it a shot anyway. I never got a chance to give the original one a shot, so seems like the perfect time to go in. My question is whether it's an update or whether it's a brand new game that you have to
yeah.
buy. So that's something that remains unanswered to this time. But again, watch the trailer below, and you'll get to make up your own mind. And then One of the last pieces of news we have here is that Eve is getting a, quote, huge new ship.
A huge new ship.
Which like, is cool.
Is the ship itself huge, or is it just a big update?
Apparently, it's a big old ship. Yeah. So it says here, we are pleased to confirm that when April 6 rolls around and FanFest gets underway, we'll be releasing footage of an exciting new development from New Eden, namely a brand new pilotable ship.
Is it paid DLC?
Bear with me. It's no ordinary ship, though. This one is EVE Online's Erebus. And the Erebus, which you'll be familiar with if you played EVE Online, is a Galante Federation's Titan and dwarfs anything yet seen in Valkyrie. As such, it presents a unique challenge to pilots. While it's capable of immense speeds, it takes a touch over 107 seconds to achieve warp. So there are no quick exits of the sort you can pull off with the heavy MWD. So yes, it's slow. It turns slow. And it does not say if you have to pay for it or not.
That makes me think it's free, because if you had to pay for it, with it coming out or being out by the time they see it,
God damn it,
they would have a price there.
Footnote: this was, as you have no doubt already guessed, an April Fool's stunt. However, while we won't be bringing you a Titan, no,
Tom.
I know, we'll cut that part out.
Tom. No, keep it in. I want to show you how dumb you are.
No, I don't want to remind you how dumb I am. Okay,
all right. I'm editing. That's not you.
Yeah,
remember that.
Oh shit, you asshole.
Aha!
Anyway,
you can see how dumb Tom is. Kept it in.
I feel like an asshole.
April Fool's joke.
Yeah, fuck April Fool. Let's just start with that, because April Fool's.
Do you know what happened on
every
April Fool's
year
that was good?
What?
Rick and Morty.
Oh, that
three.
Was true. I watched that last
night.
Yeah,
I didn't watch it. I haven't watched it yet, because I've only made it halfway through season one.
The Mulan sauce. That was good. I liked it. So this is real news. I know this because I actually did it this morning. Ancient
news.
Amulator is a game in the Chinese store. So if you haven't already, VR guys, let's do this. Let's go and get a Japanese, a Chinese, and a Hong Kong account set up on your PlayStation, because those stores are always releasing free demos in VR. And as you know,
why do they get them and we don't?
I don't know. If you can't get enough,
I was about to
say
fuck the Chinese, but that was bad to say.
If you can't get enough of VR, then you're missing out on a good chunk of them if you don't have those stores signed up.
And it's
if
all region
free.
You
want to know how to do it? Fucking
Google
it. There's a million different things online. I just went to YouTube and they gave me the answers. But Ancient Amulator is supposed to be really, really fun. It's on the Chinese store. So go to the Chinese store and it's in the demo section. All you have to do is search for Ancient and it should show up no problem. And basically, when you're in the store, just so you know, if there's no yen amount or whatever it is attached to it, then it means you can download it. It's like free. So if you see, when you type in Ancient, there's a couple games. Choose the one that doesn't have a monetary attachment. It's not
in English.
Yeah. So there you go. But that's supposed
probably
to be a
Mandarin.
Lot of fun. So that's your news roundup.
Fake news.
For Level 2 VR. I feel like such a twat. but thanks again for joining us for our VR section this week. We really had a nice bump last week with you guys all watching, and it meant a lot to us. It really did. So thank you to everyone that viewed in last week. And moving onwards and upwards now, we're going to bring you some gameplay. So if you don't like doing anything but hearing us chat at your face, then you can turn off. But it'd be cool if you stuck around.
And if they're listening, they can over to level2gamers.com.
Yeah.
And check out the video.
Yeah, if you're on the podcast, because there is an audio format of this for you guys that just want to hear the news, then you can hop over to Level 2 Gamers and watch Fated the Silent Oath, played by Keegan, which is a first-person Viking game that's kind of story-based, and it's bizarre. It's almost like an interactive adventure.
We've already recorded this. We recorded this before we recorded this. Did you get all that?
Got
it. Pronouns.
Got it.
Bruna, I don't know. But anyways, from what I've read, you'll see where we ended off. We didn't get very far into the game. It does get really good at the end. But it has. I don't give away too much, but I've heard it has a questionable ending.
Mm.
But it gets good, but then gets questionable. I'm not going to say. I'm going to let them determine for themselves. So if you guys want to pick it up and play
bucks,
it,
right?
You can watch our video, see if you want it. Yeah, I think it's $10. But I highly recommend you watch the gameplay we got coming up now and see if you want to pick it up.
Keep watching and see if you want to pick it up. Apparently, there might be some cool stuff at the end of this game. So if you watch our gameplay and you think it looks cool, pick it up. Let us know. Drop it in the comments. And that's about all we have for you this week. So hopefully you enjoyed that. My apologies for the stupid fucking Eve thing. On the plus side, though, you can get Eve, Valkyrie, and Gunjack for 50 and 60% off.
This is why I'm very
26.
Glad I'm editing this.
Yeah.
I'm taking a lot of pride in
He's
this.
He's going to make me look like a dick.
I'm going to put like a dunce hat on him.
Yeah. Thank you. Great. So, fuck everybody. All right. So, thanks a lot for watching, guys. And as always,
welcome
to the
second
level.
Bye.
Chapter. New. Options. New. Chapter. New. Options. New. Chapter. Ready?
Let's do it to it.
Turn this up a little bit, though. Come. Oh, hi there.
Do you remember me?
I don't remember you.
I am Mist, one of the Valkyries. Come, ride with me.
Where are we riding to? Oh. And we're leaving.
We'll start after this.
Loading. Hello? Gonna load? Oh! Oh, Jesus. You are right on top of me. This is like Skyrim.
All right. So,
we're playing Skyrim in VR, Tom.
It does look like it.
It's really dark.
It looks like it on screen, too. Like, I think this is because it's a flashback or something.
Yeah.
It's
oh, this is little, that's terrifying.
A little cloudy. See your wife, Freya. So this is Faded.
That's my wife. Right there.
Faded a Silent Oath.
Yeah.
That's your wife.
Her
she has large
Freya,
eyes.
I believe. Come. You don't believe in Valhalla. But I don't need you to believe. This is real, like, personal space is not a thing in VR. It's real creepy.
Because she was real close to you?
Yeah. Oh, and I'm back in space.
Okay.
So I don't know what's going on here. I just had a flashback. I talked to a Valkyrie talking head. Your life's
thread is spent. I figure this is, you're discussing Valhalla, so clearly there's religious implications to what's going on. But essentially, Fated a Silent Oath is this kind of Viking story. It is an experience. It's not necessarily what we would call a fully fledged game. It is, however, only $10. And for what it is, allegedly, we're playing this for the first time, but allegedly, very well put together. So it's one that a lot of people have been looking forward to. So how do you feel so far? What do you think about the graphical fidelity and things like that?
I haven't had enough to go off of. I mean, it looks like a VR game. Oh, God. Fucking damn it. They, like, back off. Oh, there's big dude behind you. I mean, it looks good. It looks like I said, it looks like a VR game. The facial expressions are good. Her hand's clipping through some stuff, but... Like,
their eyes are terrifying to me.
Yeah. I told you, she's fucking creepy. It's real weird to my head right now. It's like in my chest.
Yeah, why are you like half dead there? Like, did you get shot or something? Or? Oh, would that explain why it's a little darker, maybe?
Yeah. I can never reveal you, okay.
You can't let people know you talk to a ghost.
I'm gonna say something. She thinks I'm dying.
Can you hear me?
Yes!
Just move your head. Nod yes if you can hear me.
Yes. Nod your head and seal the oath, Ulfur. I'm gonna nod my head. Oh, if I say no, what happens if I say no, Tom? What do you think?
What? It'd be fun if you said.
Oh, she's got color now.
Can you hear me? No. Well, clearly you can because you're responding.
She's colored now. Whoa. Okay, this looks a lot better.
Okay.
Color adds. Color adds a vibrancy to the world.
So you're
a little dark over there, though. Oh Jesus! You jumped.
You're back.
It's so the most off-putting thing is the fact again that I have no neck. Like,
I love you.
Like he doesn't move with my head.
So the location is a little weird, a little off. Okay, could be the camera, could be our fault. Let's not necessarily pin down
said.
The game
I'm gonna
with
say
that.
Yes.
By the gods, returned from the dead, but mute.
I am mute. He's here. That's her dad.
Okay. Well, the whole fam's here.
Yep. For the clan. It doesn't look like you were, like, trapped. We don't look like prisoners. Because we're not, like, caged in or anything.
No, it just looks like you're traveling somewhere.
I kind of want to, like, stand up and look over, but I'm like... And your daughter? Don't know if I can. She trade?
The fidelity looks really good. The art style looks like it's, like it gives credence to this particular style of VR game.
Oh, there's wolves. Am I getting attacked by wolves?
I mean, they're following. They're not really attacking.
Oh, there's a dead horse over there.
They're after the horse. Poor guy.
Yeah, the art style, I think, and I think it's kind of like, the way I feel about VR is because I know you're not getting the highest, sharpest image in VR, is an art style always makes it look better, mm-hmm. versus trying to go for realism.
Yeah.
So, like, the art style, like, this is cool, she's really white.
It looks like a little bit of a combination of, like, a classic sort of, you know, Disney, Pixar type thing, but mixed with a little bit of, Eastern sensibilities in terms of like their eyes being huge and stuff like that.
How do I raise my I can raise my hand.
I'd raise whatever hand is your main hand. You'll be back to your old
self in no time. Ah, that's weird. The motion's
here really, I come to raise my hand.
The motion's very rigid.
Yeah.
But is this like, am I just going to sit in the back of this caravan for a while?
I think you're just in prologue mode right now. We won't do the whole game, obviously, because we don't want to spoil it for you guys, but just so you get an inkling of kind of what you're getting in for with this this game. And so far, it looks really, really pretty. Like, I do actually like the graphics a lot. I'm not sure what it looks like on your end, but I mean, on our end, it
looks
great.
It looks good because the art style, it's not, like, super crisp. Like, I know I'm in a fake world, obviously, because of the art style, but I think the art style does credence to it, to making it feel like I'm in a world that's...
Right, right. How's the voice acting?
It's pretty good, other than her getting real creepy up in my face. Like, of all the things, my big complaint right now is just how close she gets to me. And, like, I can adjust it, obviously, by, like, recentering the camera, but that doesn't... Oh, God, now I'm off. Here we go. Like, I feel like that she's still all up in my grill.
Yeah.
Right now, right now she's like an arm's reach away, which feels right because his hand's right here. If I was sitting like he is, his arm's bent and he's like this. So we have the same length of arms. Granted, his elbow's a little bit. He's got a shorter bicep than I do. But I can only hope to remain as brave as my own daughter until we find her again. Uh-oh, our daughter's missing. I really wish there was subtitles.
Yeah. They are noticeably, absent,
I look for them.
Aren't they?
Uh-oh.
You have to be paying full attention. Cropper
destroyed. Oh. And the bridge.
Look at the
bridge.
What happened?
Where's the bridge? What kind of sorcery is this? That's a town destroyed.
Oh.
And the bridge is gone. See where the bridge should be? Oop, there's a microphone in front of me. Sorry, yeah. That was really loud. You see where the bridge should be right there?
Yeah, yeah.
The bridge is destroyed. Children. The children!
That's not good.
Survivors will be at the lake. We're heading to the lake. Are you going to speed up? Ha! Oh, he did, but we fade to black.
Hmm. So far, very on rails.
Yes.
When
hope fades, act one. Here we go.
Let's hope that was just the prologue. Yeah, and you actually get to do stuff.
Oh, jeez. Oh. Things a lot brighter. How do you feel? Can you walk?
I mean, do I have choice?
How do I walk?
Nod your head. Oh, they're asking you to actually walk, I think. Freya. Oh. Oswald. Who's this geezer? I'm sorry, I didn't recognize
you. Freya and Oswald. I need to know. Have you seen Liv and Sven? Yes. The complaint from the, like, we're talking about graphics is very stiff hair.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. As you know, I am a hair fan.
And his whatever the fuck he's got on his back there.
They've all got kind of Lego hair. And still needs convincing. We must prove your strength, or these desperate people will. Plus the
God, your eyes are freaky.
Timing
there.
Stuff is all fucked up. Come, let's find the
children. I gotta go find the children. Oh God. Okay, we're moving. I've never played a game, by the way, that I've moved with the left stick.
Ah, so this is new for you.
I don't think I have. So
be very careful then.
Yeah.
Queasiness is definitely a thing. Is it smooth turning?
No, because there's not any.
Gotcha.
I turned it to the shortest degree I could, which is 20. Oh, hi, horse.
I mean...
Hi. Oh, you were scary looking with your black eyes.
Yeah, he doesn't... He has no eyes. Maybe they stole the horse's eyes, and that's why they're so big.
Oh, this is... That's weird. I've never... Oh, I can see myself moving.
It definitely... So what it does when you're sat down is it gives you what we call the flying carpet effect.
Yeah.
Where you feel like, you know, you're on a carpet and you're hovering forward because you know your body's motionless, yet your character is moving. I'm pretty comfortable with the left stick movement, though, I gotta say.
I can't, like, center
on him. I hate the incremental turning, though.
Hold on.
Yeah, there's no way to change it.
Yeah.
Sucks.
Rotation, angle, speed. Comfort helper. No, there is, see? The D-pad.
I don't know if that's... I mean...
See, oh, so here you go.
Can you do smooth?
No, I think 20 was the lowest I could go.
That's bullshit.
Let me actually look at you now. That's good that they let you do. So here's... They have comfort helpers. So you have volume cubes... Volume cubes. You have the sphere bubble, sphere lines, floor symbols, square floors.
So they do have quite a few options, just not the one that most people want, which is smooth turning. Or this peace may not
last until Gudbrand's help arrives. I've always wondered, like, what the thought behind this. Oh God, you walk through the sphere. God, would you get out of my bubble, please?
This bitch.
Let me back up here. Oh God, you look dead. Are you talking to me? Oh, you're talking to her. I just happened to be in the middle of a conversation.
Hi. Oh, that is creepy as fuck.
What am I doing? I wasn't paying attention.
I don't know.
Go follow her to the children? Okay.
I guess. Just wander around, see how far you get.
Yeah, this is... So, this, like... Again, I've never played a game where I move with the stick. I feel like a Steadicam.
Yeah.
That's what it reminds me of. Like, so I feel like I'm... My brain knows I'm not moving, but I am moving, because it's like, oh, you're doing a Steadicam.
I
was hanging the wash and
a wind came so strong. I guess you can't really talk to these guys.
Kick you in the water.
We're all out of home. I don't know where you're supposed to go.
I don't either. I wasn't really listening to conversation. I can lift my arm now.
Do you have like a quest log or something? Or? No one
else is coming. Not that I saw.
I mean, at least the I was scared it was going to be on. Oh, I guess you got to follow her. I was scared that the movement was going to be all entirely on rails and you'd just be like responding to things. So I'm glad that they do give you a little bit of freedom.
So
even if it's only a tiny bit.
Her, she's real fuzzy right now at a distance.
Right.
They look really good when I'm really right next when I'm up next to them.
Gotcha.
Like. It's like, so this is like, if I took my glasses off right now, this is, it's like her face, I can't see any features.
Okay.
But yeah, the movement, I'm it's not bad.
You don't feel nauseous. It is slow, which is noticeable. Alright.
Oh yeah, I gotta follow her. We're gonna go find the children.
Find the children!
So is this a, like, follow me? Ooh. Yeah, the turning's a bit wonky. Like, I feel like it's a stop to turn.
I hate degree turning, it's so frustrating. We know at this point in time that smoothness...
Oh God, something just flew through me.
...or smooth directions are the way to go. Because every company that's released a game that has that option, people love that option. Because, I mean, the more you play, the less likely you are to need the incremental thing to begin with, because you get your legs.
I don't know what's happening, but every so often I'll get a flash of, like, black, and I don't know if it's something going through me or if it's just the game... having issues, but
could
like
be.
It looks almost like a screen tear happening on the screen. Like I've had it on the bottom right, the bottom left, and I had it right there, just flashed.
I just saw that. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Looks like it might be a glitch.
But it's definitely.
Yeah, I just saw it again.
Not good. Yeah, there's. Yeah, see, like if I move quickly, it just like it doesn't know what to do.
I don't think it's that. I think it's loading or something. Like, or maybe it could be.
Frame
hey,
I found
rate
the kids.
Drop.
How come you can run? Actually, I probably don't want to run. Freya. That's our daughter's, apparently.
Freya?
Well, the mom's name's Freya.
Yeah. You made it.
I had a vision you were...
You're not our daughter.
Everyone's a little sweetish and blonde.
Hey, it's the person from the trailer. Hi. Oh.
Silly girl, what are you afraid of? Go!
Would you recommend it to fans of Vikings? Sick about you.
Liv, what's wrong? What?
Would you recommend it to fans of Viking mythology?
I don't know yet. Just has some trouble with his voice. I mean... Everything is all right. Have you ever seen something stereotypical Viking that wouldn't play in it? Just that's right now. The story seems pretty generic, other than being in the back of the carriage. I felt like I was in Skyrim. We're going to find the safest place. She looks like a doll. All right. Oh, hi there.
They definitely have dead eyes. Then, what do you have
there? Bow. We were going to hunt.
We were going to hunt.
That's an excellent instinct, nephew. Your father would have been proud.
Oh, there's leaves falling in the background. Where did you find the bow? See?
Through there. I think he's dead.
Finn was afraid to touch him.
Oh, so you're gonna go find a dead person.
Who? A warrior. A captain.
I don't like this guy because he stutters, and I don't know if it's because he's scared to tell the truth or if it's speech impediment.
Well, if it's speech impediment, you'd feel pretty guilty about that.
I
right?
would, but it's also just like...
He also has a wicked rat's tail.
Yeah. The fact... Do I need to follow him?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
You're supposed to be following the kid.
The fact that they, like, walk through me is kind of weird. Yeah, I wish I could, like, center on him. There we go. That's kind of centered. It's still off.
Look at that rat's tail, though.
The boat. I'm sorry. There are kids up there.
There are kids up there. He definitely has to have a speech impediment.
Yeah, and you were picking on him.
I tried to see if he was alive, but I didn't get very close.
Because, again, I didn't know at first if he was scared or not. Uh-oh. Going into a cave. Real dark in here. Oh, excuse me. I feel like I'm hitting my head on that rock. Oh.
He doesn't look dead.
I mean, he looks as alive as everybody else.
I guess he looks
else.
A little dead.
Nope.
There he is.
He's alive? I'll go get help.
Told you, kiddo. Boy.
Take my things. Kill Gunbrand Traitor.
Kill Gunbrand Brand Traitor.
So we're going
to kill whoever. I have a feeling our goal is to kill whoever killed. Oh, Jesus.
Gunbrand? That's the Jarl.
Grandfather the Jarl? Said he would...
So, if you're going to give him a stutter, and this is, I can't get over this, at least make his lips stutter with him.
Do you think he's a traitor?
Well, the lips don't match up too great. Anyway.
Maybe you're right.
I said he's
I
not...
I do like that that you can respond to people with the nods. He's I have going. To say that.
We should go now.
That's an interesting mechanic you don't see a whole lot.
Yeah, God, I wish I could just turn around.
Except for maybe Gary the Gull. Look at him just off by one with the trumpety trump.
Yeah.
Trump.
They walk a lot faster. So I like, because it's a lot of follow me quests, but I like, oh, there's a circle I gotta walk into to set things off. Do you see that?
It's too big for me.
He's giving you the bow and arrow, man.
You know how to hunt, right? Even though you're not a warrior?
No, I don't.
You're
calling
not a warrior, little bitch.
And then that.
Yeah, bish.
Oh, I'm gonna say no. Sorry.
That's all right. I can help. You should start with target practice.
Oh, I just got another one of those. Oh, those glitches are happening.
I see them, yeah.
I'll make targets.
Can I shoot you? There we go. Oh, hit him. Bam! Bam! What am I shooting?
Nailing it. You're shooting the shield.
Try the big tree trunk first.
Big tree trunk.
Okay.
Is it this? Oops.
Good.
Yeah.
Now the shield?
Now the shield? I feel like my aim's a little bit off. Hold on, let me recenter here.
And as a final test, this doll.
Okay, good. That aim's a little bit better. I had to recenter there, and I was ready. Better. Am I ready?
Are you aiming with your head there?
Yeah.
Gotcha. That's the best way to aim weapons in games, I think. That worked really well in Resident Evil.
Yep. Oh, I can't just shoot?
Do you think they missed a trick with the... They could have used move controllers here with the arrow and everything?
Maybe. Can I grab those?
Lift stall. She kept hitting me with it, so...
That's his sister's doll. So, I don't know if you heard that, but she kept hitting him with it, so he took it to use it for target practice.
Little serial killer.
Yeah. I don't know how long I can play with this this motion thing.
That's okay. We're going to tie it up here soon. I just kind of want to see what happens next.
Who am I talking to? You?
It looks like you have enough you? There. We only need to hunt enough to feed a handful of survivors. Ha! And the captain?
Dead. He said Gudbrand was a traitor.
He is a traitor. And a thief as well. I don't know why Father respects him so.
May the force be with you.
I saw a nobleman, and also with a god, you. And a giant.
But not you, fuck you.
Whispers. Could it have been Gudbrand?
Those eyes.
Let's discuss this.
She's creepy looking. Then, like, the rest of these people are, like, somewhat normal. She's scary looking.
I'll help track them.
What's on her chin?
Oh god, don't run through me.
What's on the blonde chick's chin?
I don't know. Oh.
Where are you going, ho?
We're going this way.
Over here.
Trying to examine your face.
They're going back to town. I gotta follow him.
Alright.
I mean...
I guess do whatever it is that he wants you to do and we'll call it so as not to ruin the rest of the game.
Yeah, part of me wants to, like, be able to run, but part of me is like, there's a reason I probably can't run.
Now, you... So I was of the same opinion... playing Resident Evil, like, I didn't want to run to begin with because I was worried about getting nauseous. But the more you get used to it, the more it's fine. Like, you do it and you don't even think about it. But you do have to build the legs up before you can go running. So it would be nice to have had it as an option, at least, because otherwise you're trundling around everywhere at this sort of mega slow pace. But also, because this is like an experience, there's also a certain amount of them probably wanting you to take it a little bit easy and absorb the environment.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I'm seeing them too. Yeah. Quite a few glitches going on, which not cool for VR. Glitches are fine and dandy, but in VR, you really have to be careful because you're fucking with someone's brain.
Yeah. Especially if it's red on your face.
Not enjoyable.
Oh, what am I shooting?
Can you crouch?
No.
I guess there's something in the bush, maybe? I would let him sneak up to it first.
To the left.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, I'm his uncle, by the way.
So you gotta kill a deer? That sucks.
Good. Right in the butthole.
Oh! Death by sphincter arrow.
Is there any other one? Nope, okay. I wonder if it's where it's actually... Oh, it disappeared. I was going to say, I wonder if it's going to stay where I shot it.
Well, you don't have any life juice to bring it back to life, so I think it's going to be just fine.
Unlike you. With your life juice. Hello?
We should try to hunt some more.
I'm hunting some more. I kind of want this, like, I feel right now I'm really closed in. I want this to, like, open up.
Yeah.
To, like, a...
I don't think it will.
Just, like, a... Not, like, open up as in, like, go anywhere. As in, open up as in, like, a vista or something. Just to show me the world.
Right, right.
In the distance.
I see them.
Like a meadow or something.
Yeah, just something that's, like, oh, hey, this is the world you're in. Because right now I just feel like I don't really care. Ooh, buddy.
Missed him. Oh yeah, like he's not startled at all by that.
Yes. I should wait for him to stop. I think there's another one.
To be fair, that was a good shot.
Well, thank you. I'm good at
quite the distance.
I played some Horizon for a little bit.
Do you have infinite arrows?
Yeah, there's no ammo. I wonder if here's an idea.
See, now would be a good time to be able to run.
So there's no, like, I guess power meter to when I hold the arrow?
I don't think so.
So it's like, if I hold it, if I just flick it versus if I hold it. Let's just go check this out. Oh, nope.
Well, he's fucking off over there now. You don't even, I thought you were killing it for food. You're just leaving it there?
I have no idea. I'm learning how to hunt from my nephew.
Yeah, it's weird that your nephew's teaching you how to hunt.
Well, I said because I didn't know how to hunt.
Yeah, that's true.
So I wonder if this is just a... I feel like this would still probably happen.
You should have been like, of course I know how to hunt, bitch. I taught your daddy. I'm going to snipe this rat tail off your fucking head. Give you a goddamn haircut.
I have a feeling there's going to be like a bear or
he's
something.
He's like the combination of the worst two hairstyles. A rat tail and like that Nazi thing that a lot of people have where they have the shade sides and the thing on top. Nazi rat tails, man.
I want there to be like a bear. I'm like walking like a inside bear. Of you. Like to shoot something bigger than a deer because right, deers right. don't come back.
Uncle.
Oh.
Well, let's trees. Find out.
Through the trees. Oh.
We're like a mountain lion.
You got it.
No, you didn't. Did you say you got it?
Yeah.
It ran the fuck away.
Oh, I might have to get another headset here.
Okay. I think that's a good place to call it anyway, honestly. That's so you can pull your headset off if you're feeling a little woozy.
Yeah, that last one just got me.
Okay. All right. So, Fated, the Silent Oath.
I would say get your VR legs before you try and do that one.
Okay.
Like, I felt good, but then all of a sudden, it's just like, nope.
Sudden wave of nausea hit
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I was like, I'm gonna not want to get sick.
That sucks.
So, but yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's interesting.
Couple glitches here and there.
I feel like if I just put the headset like this.
Yeah, just play it then there, yeah, sure.
I can't aim, though. That's the problem.
Couple glitches here and there. Definitely bulky, kind of dumb.
Very slow.
Sluggish. But not horrible. Like, there's... you did get it.
Yeah.
There's a decent amount of stuff going on in here to keep you half entertained. And bear in mind, this is a $10 game, too. So I think that for $10, you're largely getting your money's worth if you really just want a small VR experience. How creepy is that? So yeah, that's Fated, the Silent Oath. Your overall is...
I enjoyed it. Like I said, if you've not played VR, probably play some other games that you don't do this motion thing. This is the first, like I said, this first game I've done that in.
So it's important.
Where the hell did you come from?
Who fucking knows? But it's important to have the legs, you think.
Yeah, but this is interesting. I think the story could potentially get really interesting of what's going on, but I don't know what the conflict is.
Right.
I just know we were on the wagon and then our town burned down, but I don't know if this is... A flash forward, flash back, same time frame. Like, yeah. I'm...
There's
I don't know.
Potential.
Yes. But so there's a chance it could be really good, but as of right now, I'm not gripped. Yeah. But that doesn't mean there's not going to be something that's going to happen. Oh,
so I guess the question is, make up your own minds, kiddos. This is... Keegan's general experience so far has been okay.
Yeah.
You do need your legs. Oh, definitely, God. It's kind of weird in places.
Am I pushing the wheel?
This okay, is I'm definitely a weird thing. But yeah, that's it, man. So that's it for your Friday VR. Thank you so much for tuning into the chat section. Thank you so much for watching the gameplay.
One more thing here.
Sure.
I'm on rails. I can't turn in this point. Yeah, I can turn my head, but
there's
I can't.
A lot of popping going on in the background there. Did you see that tree just came out of nowhere?
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, it's a little janky. So, not terrible, but a little janky.
Yeah. Nothing probably an update can't fix.
Yeah, exactly. So. All right, cool.
Right.
So that is Fated, a Silent Oath. It's $10. It's on VR, and it's half interesting.
Yes.
And half glitchy.
So.
Take a look.
Thank you guys for watching.
And as always.
Welcome to the second level.
Bye. It ain't no game, but they saying welcome to the second level.